Hello, we are from team number 323. As a part of previous challenge, we are here to discuss about the company analysis of India's largest port operator. So, for easy understanding, we divide our presentation into three parts. First part deals with company introduction and its presence in India. Second part deals with company's financial analysis. Third part deals with its peer comparison and rating given by different companies in India. And concluded by our rating based on our analysis. So let me start with introduction of the company. It was founded by Gautam Adani, Managing Director and Chairman of the Adani Ports. And currently company is headed by Karan Adani. It engages in the business of port developing, maintaining, operating the port facilities. And its subsidiaries, it has 28 subsidiaries. And one of the important subsidiaries was Adani Kattupalli Port Private Limited. And it was listed in the year 2007, and presently it is trading around 355 rupees. And coming to the financial highlights of the company for the year 2018 and 19, and company's revenue was at 10,925 crores, which is a decline of minus 3.25%. It is because of decrease in the revenue from the container infrastructure operations. And coming to the ROC, which is a good for industry, that is 13.5%. And debt to equity is not that much good and not bad, that is 1:1, and this is because of the debt and increase in the debt. And coming to the EBITDA margin, which is at minus 1.09%, 7067 crores. Decrease in the EBITDA margin because of the foreign exchange loss incurred by the company for the period 2018 and 19. And coming to the PAT, which is most important to analyze in a company, and this is good with 8.7%. And this is because of the decrease in the current tax. One of the positive points which makes us to feel that to give the good rating was company has a capacity of 400 million metric tons, and currently it is handling the 208 million metric tons, and to their vision was to reach 400 million metric tons for the period 2025, and acquiring a Krishnapatnam port is part of that, and which increases directly 57%. 57 million metric tons. As we all know, company was incorporated in the year 1998 and started its operation in the year 2001. And in 2011, it has achieved its milestone of 50 million metric tons. And past 5 years was a growth picture for Adani Ports. And in past 5 years, it deals with many mergers and acquisitions and went for many fundraisings from foreign. One of the positive points we consider for our credit rating was the company increased its stake from 22% to 27% by acquiring the Krishnapatnam port. So it is a positive point where the company stake was increased to achieve its vision of reaching the 400 million metric tons of cargo capacity. As a part of our analysis, its presence also matters. So totally it presents in 10 locations with 6 ports and 4 terminals. And one of the important port was Mundra port, which was located in Gujarat and with 26 berths. And handling capacity of 231 million metric tons of cargo. And important terminal was Suna terminal, handling 35,000 million metric tons of cargo. And one of the important port was Dhamra port, handling capacity of 100 million metric tons. And presently it is operating at 40 million metric tons. And this company is also entering into the commodity cargo handling.
Now let's go through business model of Adani Ports. Adani Ports is into ports, logistics and storage. It's mainly in the dredging and the reclaiming solutions. It is having 395 million metric tons per annum. It has aimed to utilize the full capacity by 2025. Let's move to logistics. It also provides a facility of moving a cargo from port to its destination. It is also having 20 years license to operate through rail. Now let's move to storage. Adani Ports is having a land bank of over 8,481 hectares, and this is used for storage of cargo. It earns through annual rentals. Now let's move to SWOT analysis. Let's talk about strengths. Adani Port is one of the largest multi-ports in India, and it is also a capital dredging capacity in India. It handles over 15% of India's cargo. Let's come to opportunities. Now, Adani Ports is moving to renewable energy, and it is also having a capacity to expand its countries. Now let's move to weakness. First one is it has allegation of environmental violation and has a limited reach within the country. When we look at threats, it is facing a problem of fluctuation in coal prices and it may have to follow strict rules for environmental violation. Ratio analysis. By using these ratios, we have credited Adani Ports. Let's talk about quick ratio. From the 5-year start, we can observe that quick ratio is less than 1 out of 5 years. From this, we can conclude that a company is unable to pay, company may not be able to pay its current liabilities using liquid assets. 2018 is exceptional to this because in 2018 there was a decrease in short-term borrowings. Second one is current ratio. For the past 5 years, current ratio is less than 1.5 and 2018 is exception to this, and even the previous reason holds same for this. In 2019, current ratio is 1.5. From this we can conclude that current assets are more than current liabilities and company will be able to pay its current liabilities using its current assets. Third ratio is interest coverage ratio. From the chart we can observe that all the 5 years interest coverage ratio is above 3, which is the standard ratio for interest coverage. From this we can conclude that a company can pay its interest liabilities out of its revenue. Let's talk about debt to equity. From this chart we can observe that debt to equity ratio is more than 1.0 for the past 4 years. From this we can conclude that debt is more than the equity and company is financing its operations through debt when compared to equity. CDSCR ratio. From this we can conclude that from the 5 years the ratio is less than 1 because it has the ability to pay off its short term debt within 1 year. Moving to ROCE. Average ROCE of Adani Ports for the 5 years is 12.6, which is less when compared to its competitors. Cash ratio. Cash ratio is less than 1. Cash and cash equivalents are not sufficient to pay off current liabilities. Next is PAT margin. From 2018 to 2019 there is an increase in PAT margin, but when compared to 15, 16 and 17 it is low because the company has spent a huge amount on acquisitions.
And continue with the ratio analysis. Gross current asset ratio. The company's gross current asset ratio is more than the 1, which means they have more operating assets which can easily be converted into cash through operations, which will be helpful for them generating more income in the future. Now, from 2015, the ratio is increasing. And it, in current year it is above 2%, which means the company is constantly increasing their operating assets. Now liabilities to assets. The liabilities assets here company is maintaining 56.5% of company's assets are funded through debt. So from these we can conclude that company is operating by using debt when compared to equity. And gearing ratio, it defines the capital structure of the company. Company's ideal gearing ratio should be in a range of 20 to 50%. Lesser the ratio, lesser the benefit to the company, but it is above 50%. Here we can see that, which is not good sign for the investors to invest. Coming to NCATD, which means net cash accruals to debt ratio, the company has the ability to pay the 55% of its debt through its generating cash. We also considered company's compound annual growth rate of so here we look at market capitalization, cost of equity, price to earnings, price to cash flow from operations, and enterprise value. So here if we look at the chart, in this the market capitalization for 1 year is 4.75, and if you look at for 10 years it is 11.31. so in a broad range of for longer period, the company's market capital is increasing. And if you look at in 5 years range, it was in 21.68, which is very huge. And coming to the cost of equity is increasing, constantly increasing from past years, and it is in 5% range from 3 years. Price to earnings ratio. If you look at the other three parameters, these parameters are affecting the companies. That's why we consider this parameters in credit rating of the company.
So now let's look at the cash flow statement analysis of a company based on few ratios. So first ratio is cash flow coverage ratio, which is indicated by the blue bar. You can see here it is increasing over the years, which indicates that the company's debt paying capacity is increasing over the years. And the next ratio is cash flow margin ratio, which is indicated by the green bars. So which is more or less stable, but in the year 2019 it has slightly increased, which means that company is able to generate enough operating profit from the sales. And so now let's talk about the current liability coverage ratio, which is indicated by the orange bars. So here you can see that it is highly volatile. In the year 2018, it has drastically increased. It is majorly due to reduction in the short-term borrowings. And in the year 2019, it has reduced. It is because of increase in the short-term borrowings, which the company has increased over the years due to expansion. So now talking about the cash flow to net income ratio, which is indicated by the blue bars. So we can see that it is increasing over the years, but then in the year 2016 it has reduced. It is majorly due to a decrease in the debtors, which led to the decrease in sales. So now let's talk about next ratio, which is cash flow to net income ratio, which is indicated by the blue bars. Here we can see that it is increasing over the years, whereas in the year 2016 it has reduced, which is majorly due to increase in the debtors, which led to decrease in sales. So the next ratio is investing index ratio, which is indicated by the orange bars. So here we can see that investing index ratio is almost stable, but in the year 2016 it has increased drastically, which is majorly because of the companies spending a lot of money on purchasing a new plant and machinery in the year 2016. So now talking about the external financing index ratio, which is indicated by the yellow bars. Here in the year 2017 and 2018, we can see that the ratio is below zero, which is majorly because the company is spending a lot of money on financing activities, and it has spent a lot of money on increasing its debt as well as paying its dividends. So now let's compare Adani Ports with its peer based on three parameters, which is market capitalization, net income and net profit. We can see here in the chart that in all the three, Adani Ports is leading, and then it is acquiring the highest market share. And when we look at the net income graph, we can see that R Cargo is trying to compete with Adani Ports in terms of net income, but still it cannot beat Adani Ports because Adani Ports have highest market capitalization and the highest net income. We have taken Altman G-score in order to know the performance of the company. So when we look at the chart of Altman G-score, we can see that in 4 years, the company is in the gray zone, which means that it is in the level of moderate bankruptcy. Only in the year 2018, it is in safe zone. It is majorly because of the low borrowings which the company has in the year 2018. So these are the ratings given by different credit rating agencies to the Adani Ports. So we have assigned Baa3 rating to the ports based on the Moody's rating scale. And we have given this rating considering all the past parameters and whatever models we have explained. And then we have given this rating majorly due to the high debt structure of the company, which is using to expand its projects.